What's up, everybody? It's Matt Price. I know it's been a long time since I posted anything, but back at it. Today we're talking about the Burnout drum fills, track one from Green Day's 1994 album Dookie. Let's check it out. So back when I was in fourth grade, this was one of the first cassette tapes I ever got. It was like a blue cassette tape, and I was really, really intrigued by the sound and Tré Cool's drumming. This first song has this four drum fills that happen like halfway through the song. And when I heard this when I was a little kid, it just blew my mind how fast he was playing. Full tempo is, I think, around like 182, 184, something like that. So I'm gonna break these drum fills down today at half speed, 50%, 75% speed, and then full tempo. And when I demonstrate them, I'm gonna play each fill four times in a row and then also play the full break. So before each fill, you get a kind of a vamp with the guitar, bass, and drums playing this particular rhythm. So it's just a really simple pattern. He's basically playing crash and bass drum on one and the and of one, snare drum on two, crash and bass drum on the and of two, crash and bass drum on the and of three, snare drum on four, and then just a bass drum on the and of four. So that's your vamp that repeats every time. This first fill is just 16th notes back and forth between the snare drum and the high tom. So it's just two notes on snare, two notes on high tom, two notes on snare, high tom, snare, high tom, and then it finishes with four notes on the snare drum. So here that is, three tempos, repeating it over and over again. So the second drum fill is basically the same rhythm as Phil Collins' In the Air Tonight world famous drum fill, except it's a lot faster. The way I kind of would technically analyze this rhythm is that it's the first two notes out of a three note grouping, and we're thinking in 16th notes, so this ends up giving you a 4/3 accent pattern in the first three beats of the measure. Then you just finish out with 4/16th notes on beat four. So he starts on the snare, moves up to the high tom, moves to the second tom, and then moves down to the floor tom. And you can see the sticking pattern up here that I use. It's like right, left to left, right. That's what feels natural to me, but some people I think might also want to try playing it just right, left the whole way through. That might make it easier for you. We also have the kick drum playing eighth notes through the whole thing. So that kind of gives it, in my opinion, like a more bombastic sound. So let me demonstrate that for you. Three tempos, check it out. Before we move on to fill number three, I just want to remind everybody that the key to learning this kind of stuff is really to take it slow and repeat it over and over again. These fills are fast, and if you try to rush through it, it'll probably end up sounding sloppy and you won't be totally aware of what you're playing. I know he's doing it really fast, and like a lot of people want to always just jump right into the full tempo of this stuff, but I really believe that the best way to do this is to start slow, focus on the accuracy more so than the speed. And you just want to repeat it over and over and over again until it gets to that point where you're not struggling with the pattern and it just comes out naturally. Fill number three. I found this pretty challenging to play up to the full tempo. I really had to practice it. It's basically just 16th notes, but you're accenting again in a three-note grouping. So the snare drum accents groups of three over the first three beats of the measure. So this is giving you like a 4/3 pattern. And the sticking, just right, left, right, left. But the way that I hear it orchestrated around the drum kit is basically like snare, high tom, middle tom, then snare, floor tom, high tom. Snare, high tom, middle tom, snare, floor tom, high tom. And then the last beat of the measure, snare, high tom, snare, snare. Also, kick drum, playing eighth notes through the whole thing. This is tricky to make it sound clean at the full tempo. I'm kind of had it. It was still a little bit sloppy there at like 182 beats per minute. But again, I'm going to demonstrate that. Three tempos, and I'm repeating this pattern 4 times each. When you're practicing it at home, I recommend that you do it more than that. Practice it over and over and over again until it gets easier for you. The final fill leaves a little bit more space, which I think is kind of cool and a good musical choice because the first three fills are just so quick and bombastic sounding. Final one leads real nice into the final chorus of the song. So what we got here is a flam on the snare on one, then snare on the of one, snare on two, snare on the and of two, snare on the E of three, and of three, and then a snare hit on four. So if you kind of analyze that and break it down, it's kind of like a 3-beat or like a 3/8 note beat pattern. Pretty cool, kind of going in theme with the second and third fill of that 3-note grouping thing. Then this fill finishes out with a 16th note triplet on the and of beat four, where you're playing right, left on the middle tom, and then right on the floor tom. Goes a little bit over the beat line into the chorus, left on beat one as an eighth note on the floor tom, and then a bass drum on the and of one, crash and snare on beat two. So to me, that's got a cool like a big band kind of vibe, you know, like leading in the kick to beat two of the chorus, then plays through. So again, I'll demonstrate that three tempos. And each time I will play the pattern 4 times in a row. All right, that's it for today's lesson, everybody. Hope you got something out of this. Tré Cool, he was kind of one of my first really favorite drummers back when I was a little kid, and I thought he was super fast and super awesome. These fills kind of a little bit tricky to play, honestly. The tempo's quick. It's a lot of movement in around the drum set. So for me, it was like kind of a shoulder and an arm workout, particularly the first and the third fill. So let me know below if you got something out of this. Also, take a listen to it. Let me know what your thoughts are on the orchestration of the toms, because sometimes when there's a lot of tom stuff, particularly with bass drum, it can get like muddy in the mix, and I'm not always 100% accurate. I also want to remind you, if you're watching this on a computer, if you go down to the settings in the bottom right corner, you can change the speed of this video or any video, not only to 50%, 75%, and 100%, but if you go up to the little custom thing, you can actually scroll that bar to a bunch of different speeds. So I found this really helpful for figuring stuff out. If I'm watching videos or listening to something, it's really helpful to sometimes get into like the 60% or 80% ranges. Sometimes make it nice for practicing. 90% if you're not quite up to the speed, but at 90% stuff kind of basically sounds like the full tempo. So anyway, enough of that. Thanks so much for watching, everybody. My name again, Matt Price. I am available for lessons online or in person in the Pittsburgh area. Check out my website, mattpricedrumming.com. Feel free to hit that subscribe, notification, like, all that good stuff. And hopefully I'll have time to film another video very soon. See you in the next one. Peace.